So the Savannah River Site is a unique area. It's, like I said, 198,000 acre site that the Department of Energy owns. The Forest Service at Savannah River, what they're responsible for is management of natural resources for the Department of Energy. So in certain areas, that's management primarily for wildlife, but in other areas, it's management of timber, say, for more of an industrial means. But that's how the two work together. So there are facilities out there that are of critical importance, and that's why there's security. But then there's other areas where you walk out into the woods that the Forest Service manages, you would never know that you're on a secured site. The thing about Savannah River is, this is the only time of the year when turkeys are hunted on site, so it's kind of a big deal. The event is typically a 3-day event, so we meet on a Thursday afternoon over at the Savannah River Ecology Lab off-site, and we have a safety briefing. Of course, the Department of Energy, Savannah River Site, is very much safety is their first concern with this hunt. So we have a safety briefing on Thursday that allows participants to have an introduction to meet folks that they are going to be paired with, that they're going to go out onto site with. And then on Thursday afternoon, they actually have the opportunity to go scouting.
When April rolls around and those dates are set for that hunt, my first order of business is to my buddy Tal Mims and say, hey, I want to be a part of this. I want to be a guide, a caller, whatever I can do to be a part of it. Most of the guides there work there. They have some type of employment, but this to me is very special. It's a special time of year and I'm not going to miss it. I have made some really close friends of the folks that I've hunted with. One thing that I've noticed about these hunts is the camaraderie between the hunters, the guides, the friendships that are made. It's just a great time of fellowship. It is a great event, and it's very, very special to be at.
I've been involved with the SRS Ultimate Turkey Hunt since 2010. That's when I was hired on to be a biologist with the Savannah River for the Forest Service. And from the first year that I was involved, I just realized it was my most favorite event of the year. Everyone involved is so passionate about the event that it's been just a, you know, an experience of a lifetime to be involved in. And I feel like over the years, people have really enjoyed this hunt. And now in my new role as the National Making Tracks Coordinator, I'm still involved. You know, Savannah River Site is essentially in the backyard of NWTF headquarters, so I'm thrilled to be still involved with this special event.
Each year when I go down for that hunt, I've had opportunity to hunt with veterans. And that's always very special, has a special place in my heart because of the military career that I had. But this year, I had the opportunity to hunt with a wounded warrior, and it was an honor for me and a privilege to share the spring woods with him.
I've been in the military since 1989. I spent a couple years active duty with the U.S. Army, and then I went National Guard in 2003 to the present. I went in first as a cavalry scout and as a scout sniper. Then I changed MOSs to a 21 Bravo, which is a combat engineer. Went to EOD school, got my route clearance certification, and served in Afghanistan in 2007, 2008, and also in 2010, 2011. I was actually injured in 2010 by an IED explosion while I was dismounted. So I ended up some time in the hospital in Germany, come through Walter Reed, spent some time at Fort Gordon here locally. And now I'm recovering from my injuries for the past 4.5 years. I originally learned about the SRS Ultimate Turkey Hunt in Turkey Country Magazine. Learned about the Wheelin Sportsmen. I joined, became a member, and was drawn 2 years in a row, and I ended up harvesting a nice turkey both years. Well, this morning we got out the truck, had Travis and Chris with me, the two guides, of course the cameraman, and we were going down a logging road and we heard some gobbles. We did a couple little soft calls and had a bird gobbling at us, and we thought our best strategy was to set up in a bend on that logging road.
But there was a road bed there that funneled into a low drain where this bird was roosted. There was a drain that kind of drifted up into some larger pines, and those pines were thick. So my thought was the turkey's going to come down the drain and not mess around in this thick pine area. So we set up in a road bed, but what the great thing about it, and it plays to our advantage, is we had a little bit of a knoll to kind of get up above this road bed where we could see. So at that time, I started just to proceed as a morning hen waking up, and one of my favorite tactics off the roost is I carry a wing, and I'll take that wing and brush it against the tree limbs, maybe even take it and brush it against a bark. It's simulating that old hen's up there stretching her wings, starting to think about flying down. And to me, when you get a bird to bark back at that natural sound, he's ready, and that's a good sign. So listen for the bird. He finally got on the ground, and lo and behold, we found out there was another turkey closing the distance at the time to cut him off.
NWTF's Hunting Heritage programs are comprised of our three outreach programs, Jake's for youth under 18, Women in the Outdoors, and Wheelin Sportsmen for people with disabilities. Through these programs, we've been introducing men, women, and youth to the outdoors for over 30 years. Our Hunting Heritage Program events are designed to pass on safe, ethical hunting traditions and are held in cooperation with our state and federal wildlife agencies and other conservation organizations. For this reason, NWTF's Hunting Heritage Programs are focused on recruitment, retention, and reactivation of hunters. Recent reports have shown that the number of sportsmen and women in the United States has been declining since the 1980s.
This is particularly concerning because as hunters, we help pay for conservation, we help regulate wildlife populations, and we generate economic growth and job opportunities. One of the ways that we're making the most impact for Save the Habitat, Save the Hunt is through our Save the Hunt coordinators. These individuals are key volunteers in each state that are leading the charge for recruiting, retaining, and reactivating hunters in their state. These coordinators are a strong network of leaders who work with state and federal agencies and other partners to ensure that the NWTF programming in their state is the best that it can possibly be.
Once we got set in, Travis, who was an excellent turkey caller, started hitting the calls just right. Not too much, not too little. He brought the bird right into us. Once we spotted the bird, he laid off just enough and talked just enough to get that bird to come in. He zoomed right in on the gobbler. Montana decoy, great decoys.
And then finally, you could hear that distinctive spitting drum like he was in a 55-gallon drum coming out of those woods right down that road.
And I'd just like to thank SRS, the Savannah River Site, for sponsoring and hosting the event. All the sponsors, NWTF, everybody that was involved, the volunteers, everybody that helped out with the hunt every year, it just makes it a tremendous hunt, and I'm thankful that they do put something, you know, like this on for us wounded veterans to go on a hunt like this and of this caliber. We really appreciate it.
The reason I'm so involved with the NWTF is they're so proactive with getting our kids involved. My daughter hunts with me, and we've been coming to this for the last 6 years, 7 years. And so not only with the kids, but with the women in the outdoors. So she will transition from youth right into women of the outdoors activities. So there's things for everybody. There's families in camp. We had more girls in camp this year than we've ever had. We're at the youth camp for Unit 23, and it's a collaborative effort between the National Wild Turkey Federation and some other state and local game organizations. The NWTF has been involved in this for probably, I think, from the onset. The thing that I think the NWTF does better than most organizations, and why I'm such a big advocate for them and why I enjoy being a part of it, is they pull our youth into it, and that's the future.
So what's unique about these partnerships is they're formed of a lot of different hunting conservation groups representing different species. In the past, those groups would not sit in the same room and talk to each other. But as we realize the threat of losing our hunting heritage, we one by one decided that we need to turn our hats backward, go to work and solve the problem.
Yeah, we're up here at the NWTF, National Wild Turkey Federation, Marv Robbins Memorial Youth Turkey Camp. We're out here with Daniel. It's a great opportunity for Daniel and I to have some time in the woods together. We spend a lot of time when he's doing athletics down in town, but when we're out here, it's just he and I, and we get a chance to hike and just talk and share and grow a little closer together on these trips. We're truly blessed to have the opportunity to be out here with some good friends as well that we hunt with today and yesterday afternoon, and just sharing those experiences as Daniel's able to spend some time with kids his own age out in the woods instead of just with adults.
It's a great time getting out here, go hunt with my father, hang out with my friends. It's a great time.
So for an event like this, Arizona Game and Fish Department is primarily a facilitator. We help out with a grant program that helps cover some of the expenses to an event like this, as well as other resources and equipment, from road signs to connection with our wildlife managers and field studies and things of that nature.
Started 2 to 3 years ago with a partnership between Quail Forever, mainly the Mark Twain Quail Forever chapter, the National Wild Turkey Federation, the Missouri Department of Conservation, and Friends of the NRA, all combined with our landowners, which are a vital important to what we're doing, as well as our youth and new hunters. Takes a lot of volunteer hours, mainly between the volunteers getting everything coordinated with the landowner so that we get the fields ready for these hunts. So it takes a lot of time, but it's well worth the effort.
It's been a tremendous experience. The kids and their parents really seem to enjoy the opportunity to come out and participate. No, I think it's just a tremendous experience, and we're happy to provide the opportunity both to the kids and their parents.
Today we're having two sessions. I think there was 13 this morning. There's going to be 10 to 12 this afternoon. But over the two-day event, there'll be about approximately 40 new and youth hunters.